Jordan from ENTTEC here. Today we're going to tackle the basic functions of the S-Play in under 6 minutes. The S-Play is jam-packed with heaps of features, so let's get to it. The homepage gives you the perfect overview of the current status of your S-Play. Starting at the top, you have the level of your internal storage, the CPU load, the temperature of your S-Play, and the current date and time, which is based on the location settings of your S-Play. From here, you can switch between light and dark mode, English and Chinese language, as well as log in, get immediate output information from your S-Play, and lock the S-Play device. If you decide to lock the S-Play, users without the username and password will not be able to change settings or playlists or have access to most of what the S-Play has to offer. They will, however, be able to play, pause, stop, and dim the intensity of any playlist on the home screen. Any playlists that you don't want on the home screen can be hidden from view. Moving on to the queue section. Here you get an immediate overview of all your queues, which can be sorted by ID, queue name, queue type, duration, or you can simply search for them. To create a queue, you simply click the plus button and then select the type of queue you want to create. Once selected, you can type the queue name and configure the required parameters. You can also preview the queue before saving. There's also a handy new info button that allows you to quickly display the output information of each universe of the S-Play and monitor outgoing data in real time by clicking the eye icon. An event is a single action triggered by one of many different protocols, and it can be placed on a playlist timeline. These allow you to integrate the S-Play with external systems by placing events in the playlist's playback. Network-based events such as UDP, ARPANET, SSEN, and OSC can be broadcast or sent to the local host to activate playlists, stop, or play triggers on the playlist timelines. This allows you to create complex and potentially interactive installations. To set up an event, press the plus here. Select the type of event and fill out the relevant parameters to use. Then click Send Event to test that the parameters are correct before saving. Triggers are an awesome feature that allow for endless possibilities. They're accessed via the external context or via RS-232. To set up a trigger, click on the plus button, then fill in the prompts. This will vary depending on the type of input you've selected. Once you've created your trigger, press Save Trigger. Just like events, you can filter your triggers through ID, protocol, and name, or you can just search for the particular trigger you're wanting to edit. This is where the fun begins. Now that we've created our queues, events, and triggers, we can begin to bring it all together with playlists. Using the timeline down the bottom, you can drag and drop your queues, events, and/or triggers to create the playlist you desire. Once your items are in your timeline, you can change the placement of each item to start and stop at your desired time. You could also add a fade-in for each queue to get a smoother transition. You can also finally change the opacity of each queue. By creating a schedule, you can customize when each playlist is played. You can have it change with intervals from seconds to weeks to months to years, or even according to the moon cycle. Astronomical. Once we've decided the schedule, we then select the playlist or all playlists, and we can add when you want your playlist to start, stop, or pause. This can be a specific date and time, or you can set it for sunrise or sunset. The S-Play automatically tracks when the sun is due to rise or set based on your location settings. You can also offset this to get your playlist to begin just before or just after sunrise or sunset to make the change in natural light suit your project the best. Finally, you can select what date you want your playlist to end on or how many repetitions you want it to complete before stopping. Interfaces are perfect for anyone who wants to set up a quick, clear page where you can control the basic functions of your playlist. If you'd like to make one, you first start by pressing the plus, then give your interface a name and a URL. Group it for clean organization, and then press save. Once the interface is saved, you can go in and customize it by clicking edit. This window here lets you add widgets for various functions such as play, pause, and stop, as well as allowing you to set the master or per playlist intensity. You can change the size, color, and location of the widgets to create a simple, personalized layout for easy control over your playlist. This section is where you can select active storage, create backups of your project, upload previous projects to your S-Play, copy from one storage location to the other, or get more information about the available storage in various locations connected to your S-Play. Here, you can change the name of your S-Play and get more information about the following settings. Output settings, ArtNet, SACN, DMX settings, network storage settings, remote access settings, playback, configuration settings, date and time settings, location settings, which are especially important if you want to have your schedules based astronomically or based on sunrise and sunset. Finally, you can update your firmware and perform a factory reset if you ever need to. So that's it, the basics of the S-Play. We hope this quick little rundown has helped you wrap your head around this powerful device. Or maybe it's given you some more inspiration to start getting into the nitty-gritty of the S-Play's capability. That's all we have today. Like, share, and subscribe if you found this video useful. Comment down below if you've got some questions or you think there's something that we missed. Don't forget to check out our social media channels and stay tuned for more S-Play and for more helpful ENTTEC tips.